I'm slicing the state out of the state. You left his car. Get his card out. Find your name. Stay safe. And the back is your name. And it's a good communication. Okay? And it is here.
That was anxiety. I ended up in the hospital for 3 nights, all because of anxiety. But now I know, because of Pastor Brian, you don't have to go fearing like that. God don't give us a spirit of fear, but a sound mind. And he's teaching every Tuesday, Wednesday night. Let me know that we don't have to do that. He got us already. All we need to do is go to the Word. It's all in the Word. And he said these days will come. Panic, I mean, dread, and then in the Bible, good brothers. Y'all know that, what is it, Acts 2:17, all the way up to Acts 22, I think it is. It's all in the Word of God. Y'all be blessed, be safe, and don't forget, we are healed. By His stripes, we heal.
I found out about today's event through my children's daycare. So we're just coming out today just to be safe. You know, the fact that there's people out here that are infecting others that have no symptoms. I mean, we have no symptoms, but knowing your status is very important at this time, so that you're not out harming other people who have conditions and health issues that are severe, you know. So that's why I'm here. Hopefully the number drops. We want that to drop in Illinois and bring that down so that we can start performing as a regular state again and doing things, you know, with our families and our friends and meeting up again. You know, that's something we have not been able to do. You know, so that's what I'm hoping for.
Okay. Yes, the first question is, why is it important? Because this pandemic, this virus is very, very serious, and we need a vaccine for it. And I found out about it through the flyer that was left at my door from the alderman's office. And that's basically about it. Okay, thank you so much.
Thank you.
And hopefully we do get a vaccine.
Right.
Okay.
Okay.
Okay, I'm a member of Alderman Politics. That's how I find out. And I think it's very important to get tested so I can protect my family, to see where I am safe around my family.
And how did you find out about today's event?
I found out through their pastor. Pastor Brown. He is our pastor, and he passed out blue shields a while back.
Thank you.
Yeah, my name is Anthony Johnson, and I'm a resident of the Roseland community. I live on 114th and Normal Avenue, and I think that COVID testing is extremely important in these times that we're living now, and everyone should take personal responsibility. And I thank Allen Metropolitan for putting on this here event for our community. So I encourage everyone to take advantage of opportunities like this to test themselves and ensure because that ensures that they're accountable and that they're not likely to spread this virus to vulnerable family members. So I once again thank Allen Metropolitan for putting on and hosting this event for the Roseland community.
Thank you.
Yes, sir. I had one test and I thought it was kind
of good. You've had a test already?
Uh-huh.
And you come back for another one?
Yeah.
You think it's important to do that? I mean,
yeah.
Okay. All right. That's good. Okay. Thank you. Thank you.
and to seek your blessing. Oh, Father, we thank you for this day, this powerful day that you've given us to take church. We thank you for this Sabbath day, God. We thank you for the blessings that you put out upon us. And we lift you now and ask for your blessing upon us, that you will minister to us and through us, and the people will be blessed, God. Yes. They're standing in line now. They're coming, God. Some got it early. Thank you for a church that will minister, God,
yes,
in the midst of a pandemic. Thank you for ministers of the gospel. Men and women of God that are not cheerful, God. They came. I thank you, God, to hold my arms up, to help me, to lift up you. And I thank you. Now bless, God, and let them see your glory. Manifest your presence, God. Let them know that you're on the throne and that all power is in your hand, God. And we ask this in the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. It's done. It's done. It's done. It's done. It's done. It's done. Oh, thank you. Hey, I want to thank y'all. I want to thank y'all. I want to thank y'all. But y'all not afraid to do ministry. I want to thank you. I thank you. I thank God for some warriors. This devil's alive. He's not going to stop us. And we're going to wipe out this pandemic in the name of Jesus. We're going to eradicate it in the name of Jesus. And some people are going to get set free in Jesus' name. The devil meant it for evil, but God meant it for good. And we're going to minister in these latter days. We are the people of God. We the church that called out. And the people are coming. The people are coming. The people are coming from nine and south. They want to be healed. They want to get peace of mind. They want to know that they're the God. And that he sits on the throne. And all power.
All power.
Praise the Lord. We give God praise and glory for this awesome privilege to just to be alive and witness another day's journey. We thank him for his goodness and his everlasting mercy that endureth through all generations. And we're thankful to be here at the Allen Metropolitan Church in Chicago, Illinois, on the south side, the land that flows with milk and honey. And we're thankful for this moment that our church could have the privilege and the sacred trust to be blessed to have the Christian Community Health Center here with us today to take testing to be done. But we are about the business of eradicating this disease, this virus that has inflicted our people, has inflicted our nation, the nations of the world, and we are coming against it in the name of Jesus. And we're thankful for this opportunity now to have the Christian Community Health Center here with us to test today. And we thank God for all of those that have come, that are in their cars now, and we thank God that they have come to be blessed, to get the results of the test, whether positive or negative, they're going to be blessed. And we pray God's blessing upon them, upon each and every one, every car, everyone that has driven in, come from near and far, those that also walked in. We thank God, and you're going to be blessed today because you're going to be able to get some results and then get some peace of mind. And then whatever is needed, you're going to be able to go forth and move forward with victory. And we claim victory for you. We thank for we have to work to eradicate this disease. And the way we do it is by testing. That's one of the most important things, that we have tests available to our people, many tests that you want to take, as often as you want to take it, so you can be clear and make sure that you are clear and that your family will be blessed, your children will be blessed, the community will be blessed. And so testing is so vital and important, and we're thankful to be able to offer it here at Allen Metropolitan Church, land that flows with milk and honey. We're thankful for the Christian Community Health Center. We're thankful for Dr. Jamisa and for all that helped to make this possible. We thank God for all the ministers of the gospel, the people of God. We thank God for this community as well. And so testing is so important. Many tests as you need to have, we're going to try to make sure that it's available to you here on the south side of Chicago, working with our community leaders and stakeholders to make sure that testing, that you can be testing. The next thing that's very important is tracing. Making sure once you've been tested, if you test positive, then to make sure that all the persons that you've been in contact with can be notified, and then they can quarantine or do whatever is necessary. So testing is important, and then tracing is so vital and important to eradicating this disease. And then we thank God not just for testing and not God for tracing, but then also for treatment, so you can get the treatment that you are in need of, and quality. I have access to quality health care for all people, irregardless of what your social status is, irregardless of what your economic status is, that you have the ability to be able, that's a right and a privilege here in this nation, one of the richest empires in the whole world, and that you can get treatment, the treatment you need, and that we have quality health care across our country and in our city for all of our people. So testing is important. Tracing is important, and then treatment is important to eradicating this disease. And I want to give you a fourth one today. This is not only testing is important, not only tracing is important, not only treatment is important, but also transformation is important. To eradicate the disease, we have to be not conformed to this world, but be renewed by the transforming of our minds. Be not conformed to this world, but be renewed by the transforming of your mind, that we may prove what is that good and acceptable and perfect will of God. We need transformation to take place. First of all, transformation in our own lives, that we're going to live differently, that we're not going to be the same when we come out of this pandemic. I said we're not going to be the same when we come out of this pandemic. We're going to be transformed, and our minds going to be renewed. We're going to live different. We're going to understand differently, and we're going to walk different. We're going to walk with power and authority. Transformation for our lives. Then secondly, transformation for the church, to help our churches to be transformed. Our churches never be the same anymore. Our church is going to be about the business of reaching out and being a blessing to people. The Lord moved us out of the sanctuary and moved us into the lives of people to be a blessing to people. And that's what transformation of the church. And not only transformation of the church, but transformation of the community. Our community is going to look different. We're not going to have the same kind of community status quo. We have a transformation of our community. So the communities are healthy. And we're going to have transformation of the medical system, have Medicare available quality health care for everyone. We need transformation of the penal system. And we need to tear down this pipeline and transform the penal system, and transformation of the justice system. Transformation of the laws are equal to everyone, and everyone has access to quality law, and are given the right that they are privileged for. And so we want transformation of our community, transformation of our cities, transformation of the judicial system, transformation of economics. We want jobs. Whatever. We need transformation in our community, and we need transformation across the line. And so we're thankful for not only testing, tracing, treatment, and transformation. And we thank God that we're not going to be the same nation that we were before the pandemic. Something's going to happen to us, and we're going to be a better nation. And we're going to treat people better and treat all people. And all lives matter, and black lives matter. And they need to know that. Everybody needs to understand that black lives matter and all lives matter, so we can be about the business taking care of all people, regardless of what color they are, regardless of their economic. And so we want transformation to take place. I'm thankful for the Reverend Joyce Dart for her ministry here at Allen and for the privilege to serve with her and all that you do in the Lord. Come on, Reverend, and say a word to the people of God today on behalf of our church and ministry. God's blessing to you. Reverend Joyce Dart, the assistant to the pastor here at the Allen Metropolitan Church. God bless you, a powerful woman of God, a praying woman of God, a woman who loves the Lord and loves people. And I thank God for you. And I thank God for your courage and your faith and all that you do for the Lord. Come on, say a word this morning.
Praise the Lord. Good afternoon, everyone. It's just an honor and a privilege to be here to serve you on today. I am Reverend Joyce Dorch. I'm Christian Aid Director here at Allen Metropolitan CME Church, the land that floweth with milk and honey. And our ministry is based on two or three foundations. The first foundation is prayer. The Word of God says that His house shall be called the house of prayer. And the Word says to be anxious for nothing, but by prayer with thanksgiving that we ought to make our requests known unto God. And I'm paraphrasing, amen. And so our ministry is built upon prayer. We have what we call a vine ministry. And that vine ministry we have a calendar. And on that calendar, each day of the week, a person is responsible to pray and fast for our pastor, for the church, and for our ministries here at Allen. And so that person, every day of the week, will fast and pray. The Word of God says that some things only come by prayer and fasting, and we know that we're living in some turbulent times, hallelujah, and so we know that prayer and fasting really needs to go forth. So we call it our vine ministry, and every day at 5:30 a.m., Minister Juanita Foster calls the person who will be fasting and praying for the day. Also, along with her will be Yvonne Rushing, hallelujah. And so they will pray at 5:30 in the morning on behalf of our pastor, our church, and our ministries. And then we have a noonday prayer vine ministry, and that's headed up by Reverend Yunita Rushing, whom you'll hear from in a little bit. Also, Minister Swanson and Minister Harris. And so 12 o'clock noon prayer goes forth. And then we have 9 o'clock vine ministry, and that's headed up by Minister Denelia Bateman, along with Sharon Hudson and also Christine Coburn. And so they go forth with the person of the day, and they pray and they fast. Hallelujah. And so then our pastor, he prays at 3 a.m. in the morning, hallelujah, and then I pray at 4 o'clock a.m. in the morning. And so prayer is around the clock as we pray and fast for not only our church, but also for the community. And so that's the first thing that our ministry is founded upon, and that is prayer. The second is the Word of God, hallelujah. The Word of God says that The word of God is inspired, hallelujah, for doctrine, for reproof, for correction, that the man of God may be thoroughly furnished unto all good works. And so we believe in the word of God. And so the word goes forth here at Allen every Sunday at 11 o'clock. The pandemic did not stop us from worshiping. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And so praise and worship begins promptly at 11 o'clock and is followed by the man of God, Reverend Dr. David L. Bryan, coming forth, bringing the word of God. You may see us on Facebook, on Zoom, and then again on YouTube. Hallelujah. And so then on Wednesday, well, let me go back. On Tuesday, we have intercessory prayer. And so you could come to our parking lot as prayer grows forth from 6:30 to 7:30 every Tuesday. And so then on Wednesday is Bible class. Bible class is here in the parking lot. The man of God will be in the upper room preaching and teaching the word of God from 7 p.m. to 8 p.m. every Wednesday. So the word is going forth despite the pandemic. Prayer is going forth despite the pandemic. And I don't know about you, but I need a word and I need prayer. And I need those two things in combination so that we can come against all that's going on in our community and in our world. We must know that we have brothers and sisters all over the world who's given up their life for the cause of Jesus Christ, and they need to be undergirded in prayer. So I'm so thankful that we can approach the throne room of Jesus Christ each and every day, all day long. And so that's what our ministry is built upon. Also evangelism. And so Reverend Yunita Rushen will now come and speak about our outreach program as we evangelize here in the city of Chicago. Thank you.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord, saints. This is a day that the Lord has made, and we shall rejoice and be glad in it. I'm so thankful that we are here today and we are able to offer this service to the community. I thank the Christian Community Health Center and Reverend Dr. Jamisa, who has helped to arrange this for us here at Allen Metropolitan, not for us, but for the Roseland community. And so we're just thankful to God for his many, many blessings. I tell you this, in the midst of this pandemic, we are individually and collectively truly blessed by our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. He has continued to pour out blessings upon us. And I believe that is because no weapon formed against us, according to the word of God, no weapon formed against us shall prosper. And if you have never been to a parking lot ministry, I invite you to come and join us on Sunday morning for an hour of power from 11 a.m. till 12 noon here on this parking lot. We have not stopped worshiping and praising God here at Allen, and we're just so excited because most of our ministries that we have to do outreach and to evangelize to the community, according to the word of Jesus Christ that said, go into all parts of the world, and lo, I will be with you. And so while some things we're not able to do, we're not able to go into the prison right now as we have done in the past. Every second Wednesday, we go into the prison on 26th in California to bring the word to those who are incarcerated there. And just let me put a pin in it, because you know, in case you don't know, our prison rate in the population in prison, we as African-American Americans and people of color, our numbers are quite large when you think in terms of our makeup in the population overall. And so we go there to take the word of God and to baptize those who are incarcerated. And let me tell you, they come forth in not large numbers to be baptized and to hear the word of God. And we're just thankful because some, when they have been released, have come here to worship and fellowship and praise God. They didn't forget that when they were in prison, somebody came and brought the word to them. And so we're excited, even though we cannot go inside the prison walls right now, we have been able to record and send messages into the prisons. So these outreach ministries are very important to us being an essential church, a community-minded church. And so when we're excited about the possibility when it opens up again that we'll be able to go in more than once a month, and we look forward to that. We have a partnership with the Greater Chicago Food Depository, Feeding the Hungry. And that's very important because people come here not only for a hot meal, but they also can get spiritual food. Their souls can be fed. They can get prayer. They can get services, other services like health insurance, the CETA program, which I'll talk about a little bit more. But we have served since October 2018, we have served well over 20,000 meals to this community, hot meals. Prior to the pandemic, people could come in, have a seat in our dining hall, and sit down and be served like they're in a restaurant. And we did not let pandemic stop us. We started to continue to prepare the meals, and people can come in, pick those meals up, and take them home, as many as they need. And so we're just so glad that we're able to continue to deliver that service to the community. We have a CASE program, the Center for After School, Culture, for the Center for Cultural Enrichment, and CACE, Center for Academic and Cultural Enrichment, CACE. That's our after school program where we partner with the school down the block, the Dunn School for Technology, and we bring the kids and the children into the church for after school program. Of course, you know all of that's continuing to change, but we're just blessed because we were able to continue to provide services to those children in their homes and to provide some support over the summer. And so we're looking forward to being able to offer that to the community again in the near future. Now I want to tell you just a little bit about the other program that we do, the CETA program, where we assist people, we help people to get the assistance they need with their utility bills. And some of you may have heard that the city now has a water bill program as well. The church building is closed, but the church work has continued. We are working remotely. If you call the church number, 773-568-1200, you can leave a message and someone will get back to you. I must tell you, we are kind of swamped with calls. It might be a week before you get a return call, but we will get back to everyone. And so if you need assistance with your water bill, your electric bill, your light bill, please call the number 773-568-1200. And if you require any other services of the church, please do not hesitate to call that number. For we are here to serve you. We are servants of the Most High God, and we're praying for you and ask God to bless you each and every day. Reverend Dr. Tanisa.
Praise the Lord, everybody.
I thank God for this opportunity today.
I thank God to see so many people who have come out to assess the resource that has been made available to you today. I noted that Pastor has talked about transformation. I thank God for the transformation and the renewal of all our minds on today. He talked about the tracking, the tracing, and all of that is your physical body. But I want to tell you there's another component to that. You are a holistic individual. We know that since this pandemic, there are many that has been suffering with anxiety and depression and need someone to talk to. A lot of us do not know where to get those resources. So today I am here. I am Dr. Janisa. I am over the director of behavioral health at St. Bernard Hospital. I am accessible to you. If you would like to receive some counseling for anything that's going on in your life, please let me know. We have one-to-one individual counseling and therapy. It's okay that the pandemic has caused some of us to be anxious, caused some of us to feel depressed because of the resources of their lacking in, but I'm here for you on today. And if you don't get a chance to stop by the mental health table, I'm going to give you the number to St. Bernard Hospital and they will connect you to available resources. 773-962-3900. Be blessed and be blessed in abundance.
Thank you, Dr. Janisa. Thank you for all that you do for the people of God. and for the our health community. And now we're thankful for the Dr. Rachel is here with us. She's from the Christian Community Health Center, and I want her to come this morning, and we want to express our appreciation to you, Dr. Rachel, for all that you all are doing for this mobile unit. The mobile unit goes where the people are. It's not stationary. It can move about to where the needs are, and we need you here on the south side of Chicago. We need testing. We need testing daily, as many, as often as we can get it, so our people can know and have peace of mind, and we can address this, eradicate this disease in the name of Jesus. It's a Christian, thank God for the Christian Community Health Center. Dr. Rachel is here. Come on, say a word, Doc.
Thank you, Pastor, for having us.
Hi, speak everybody. Loud, speak loud.
Okay.
Speak loud.
My name is Rachel Ilesomi. I am a family nurse practitioner. I work as a primary care provider with Christian Community Health Center. The Christian Community Health Center has different clinics in our neighborhood. And we do have the mobile van. We're here today. We go to different neighborhoods to help our community, to bring care. We go to schools also to do screening. And we go to different places in Chicago, South Side, West High, to help everybody that that really needs help medically. We also help families in need. We give housing. We have a money house. We have houses, different places in Chicago that the Christian community give here in Chicago. So we are so honored to be here today. We are so honored to serve our community, and we are so blessed because God has been so good to our agency. God has been so good in many ways. So more than on behalf of everybody from Christian Community, thank you so very much for having us.
Thank you for coming. Thank you so much. Thank you so much for all that you're doing. And for all of you that have come, thank you so much. Thank you for your patience. There's so many coming. We have a line now going down low. So thank you so much. Just be patient. They're going to get to everyone and to be treated today, to be tested as many as possible all the way to 2:30. So you can get on your cell phones now and you can call your neighbors, call your friends, call family members and let them know they can come here to Allen Metropolitan on 109th and Low and be tested free without any cost to them so they can have peace of mind about this erroneous disease, this virus that has afflicted our people, and we come against it in the name of Jesus, and we're gonna eradicate it, working together with the people of God to do all that's needed, first of all, with prayer. And all of you that have, you heard about our prayer ministry, and Reverend Dorch is gonna come and let you know, for those that would like to have prayer today, to let you know that we'd like to have prayer today. We're here, ministers of the gospel, and also what it is that you can receive in any kind of assistance that you need as it relates to utilities and other needs. Our church is blessed to have the LIHEAP program, as you heard from Reverend Russian, our director, and also work with the Safe Haven program with the CPS, with the children in our community. Come on, Reverend Dorch, and let them know what they can receive today.
Praise the Lord. We just want you to know that in front of the church, there are tents available, prayer tents. If you would like to, after you get tested, come on around. You could get out your car, come into the tent. We are socially distancing. But how many know that prayer is not social distance? Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. So you could get out your car. There will be a minister waiting for you to pray for you. I don't know about you, but I believe in prayer. And I believe that God sits high. And he hears every prayer. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen. You got anybody else?
Yes, we're thankful. Come on, Sister Carolyn, for testimony. We thank God for healing your sister, Lavinia, 80-some years old, and the Lord healed her of this coronavirus. And we're thankful to God for all the healing that's taking place and all that you do for the Lord. Woman of God, you want to say a word of his goodness and mercy?
Yeah.
In your life and for the life of our church and the ministry that's taking place here at Allen Metropolitan, Sister Carolyn Rogers.
Hello, everybody. I just want to thank God. I want to thank this church. I want to thank my pastor because I was at a loss. I was so afraid, and now I know that God does not give us a spirit of fear. I was so panicky and worried and not knowing exactly what to do. But through Pastor Brian's teaching and wisdom, knowledge, and understanding, I now have a better outlook on all that's taking place in my life and the life of the people of God. I just thank God that he's showing himself strong and that we are have no fears and no worries, and that if we stick together and pray, we remember that prayer is the key to this thing. And I just believe that we all get together, seek his face, be humble, and pray that we'll make it through. And so I'm just thanking him today for the people that's come to get this test, because we need to know. And we can tell other people that they need to know, because people can be carriers of it and don't even know it. So we're going to continue to follow the rules, wearing our masks, listening, giving us wisdom, knowledge, and understanding on how to make it through, and our families. In Jesus' name, I ask all of this. Amen.
God bless you all. Thank you for coming. Communicate with others. You can get on your phone, your cell phones now. Let them know until 2:30 today they will be able to be tested here at the Allen Metropolitan Church. Spread the word. We don't want any time to lapse that someone is not being tested during the time that they've given us. And so preferably we can have a reoccurring event once a month, every other month, making sure that you're tested here on the south side of Chicago. We're thankful for God for how he has blessed our community. He's given us everything that we need to eradicate this disease. We thank God for the leadership of our governor and our mayor, and our working hard for our schools and taking care of our children, for this upcoming school year. We're thanking God for the decisions that they are making, wise decisions, not to put our children right back in at risk, but to make sure that everything is in place as we prepare them to continue to learn, that their futures are bright. We want them to know that God is a good God, a great God, a magnificent God, an all-wise God, and he's a healer. And with his stripes, we're healed of every sickness and every disease. No sickness or disease can stand in the presence of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. He healed all manner of sickness and disease, and he opened the eyes of the blind, and opened deaf ears, and loose stammering tongues. He's a healer. And I said, with his stripes, we are healed of every sickness and disease, and we will eradicate. I said, we will eradicate this disease, this virus that has come against us. But the Lord declares, say, no weapon formed against you shall prosper. I said it, I won't take it back. I said, he said, no weapon formed against you, and that includes the coronavirus, formed against us shall prosper. Thank you so much. God's blessing to you. We thank God for CAN TV. We thank God for Brother Keith McDonald taking the time to come out here on a Saturday and to spend this time with us to make sure that the word gets out. We thank God for Dr. Charlotte Bronson, the owner of the Meeks television cable network. And we thank God for all of you and for your prayers, because we believe in prayer. And he declares that if my people that are called by my name will humble themselves and pray, seek my face, turn from the wicked ways, I will hear from heaven, forgive their sin, and heal the land. The land is sick. It's sick with disease and sick with sickness. But he declares he's the same God yesterday, today, and forever, and he will heal our land. I said he will heal our land. We claim it in the name of Jesus. God's blessing to you. Be safe. God is going to heal our land. Blessings to you. God bless you. God bless you. The Allen Metropolitan Church on the south side of Chicago, 11 o'clock a.m. worship right here on our parking lot. We get our praise on 11 o'clock, and then on Tuesday, intercessory prayer at 6:30 every Tuesday, community intercessory prayer right here on the parking lot. We're on Facebook. You can go and put up my name, David Bryant, or the Allen Metropolitan Church, the land that flows with milk and honey, and you can share and be a part of our services on Facebook on Sunday morning at 11 o'clock and on Tuesday. God bless you. God bless you. God bless you. Good morning. Once again, we're here at the Allen Metropolitan Church in Chicago on the south side of Chicago at the Allen Metropolitan Church, the land that flows with milk and honey. And we're thankful today that we've been blessed to have the Christian Community Health Center here to take testing, do testing for us, for our community. And we're so thankful how God has blessed us to have this opportunity to make sure that our people are tested. Testing is so important to eradicating this disease, this virus that has afflicted our people and afflicted humanity and other nations of the world and the people of God. And so we are thankful here this morning with one of our neighbors who lives right across the street from the church. And Sister Buffington, you just walked over. You didn't even have to ride. She just walked over to come and share with us to make sure her and her husband were tested. And I'm thankful for her. You know, it's a blessing to have good neighbors. And I'm thankful to you, Ms. Buffington. You've been in this community for over how many years?
Over 50 years,
and your children grew up here and attended Dunn School, and you've been living across the street from the church, right across the church. You live out, you look out your front picture, and you see our parking lot right into the front door of the church. And so we're thankful so much, and you are very much a part of the life of the Roseland neighborhood community. You worked untiringly for so many years in there, and you've been a part of the Dunn School committee working to make sure that that school is healthy. And we celebrate that just $11 million some dollars was spent on the building and our Dunn STEM Academy school. And you were very much a part of that work. And so I want you to say good morning, and however God has blessed you in terms of coming over and sharing with us. And how is it that you came over? Did you get a flyer through the feeding program, or how is it that you came over and became aware of us testing, and then you, as always, took advantage of it? You just didn't sit there. You got up and pressed your way and came on across the street. God bless you. You say good morning to the people that are watching on social media. There, many of them are watching, and some are elders like yourself. And can you help us to understand the importance of that and having the access to testing and quality health care? This is Mrs. Buffington.
Yes, Reverend Bryant, since you've been in this ministry over to this church, I want to congratulate you on the work that you've done. You're a very dedicated minister, and I watch a church out here during the week, and I listen to it, okay? We've been here, my three daughters and I, and my husband, we lived here for more than 50 years, okay? Yes. So I'm happy to see you. So congratulations to you, Reverend. Yeah. And I see people that I know, parents that I know that was at Dunn School as well out here. So thank you so much.
Well, thank you.
The work you've done here.
Well, thank you for your encouragement and just for sharing with us. And we thank you for your support. You work in the Roseland Neighborhood Community Organization, which is a community organization founded here by a church, and the Black presidents, and you've been so active there. We also are very appreciative of your support, and you watching over our church.
Yes,
you can watch over the church when we're not here. You look out the front picture window, and you can let us know all of what's taking place. And we're thankful to have good neighbors like yourself. And you want to be tested today, huh?
Yes, I do. Yes.
Okay.
So thank you for inviting everybody over here for that. And I've told my neighbors to kind of encourage them too. So thank you so much.
Well, thank you, Ms. Buffington. And you're going to get tested today. And we know whatever the test come out, you're going to be fine. You're going to be healed. You are covered under the blood of Jesus, you and also your husband and your family. Your daughter just lived right across the street too as well.
Right,
and so you all are surrounded around us, and we're thankful for you. And you have just a beautiful spirit. You've always had such a gracious spirit. Ever since I came here in 2009, you welcomed me and your family in. And we are thankful to have you as a friend, a neighbor, a sister in the Lord. God's blessing to you. Be blessed. Thank you so much. And we want you to spread the word. You have time to get on your phone. It's 2.5 more hours that they can be tested. They just only need a call, and they can come and be tested as well. Get on the phone. Make a call to someone who needs to be tested, who would like to be tested, and would be sure about if they are positive or negative, and be able to get the treatment that you need swiftly to address and eradicate this disease. In the name of Jesus the Christ, we pray. God's blessing to all of you. If you're here this morning and after you are tested and you would like to have prayer, our prayer warriors are on the line under tents, counseling. If you need information on assistance with utilities, gas, electricity, or water, our personnel, our EST workers are here, can give you information as to what you need to do so you can make an application. If your income has lessened for whatever reason, has decreased, you may qualify for assistance from our state and from the city programs that we have. Our church is a part of the LIHEAP program. So please spread the word to anyone that you know that may need that assistance. God blessing to you. Thank you for your patience, and all of you will be tested today, we can assure you. I'm so glad to see Sister Cynthia is here, Sister Jackie Griffin. I'm so glad to see her. We haven't seen you for a while. We miss you, Sister Jackie, and God bless you, Sister Cynthia. So glad you can come out and be tested. We love you and we appreciate you. And Sister Mamie is with you too. Sister Mamie is with you too, your aunt and her niece is driving, both of them to be tested. God bless you so much, Sister Mamie and Sister Jackie Griffin. I mean, they're coming from all over to be tested today. They are reaching out and bringing the family members in. And so we're so grateful. Thank you for your patience. If you like some cold water, just raise your hand up. If you like some cold water, we'll be glad to deliver it to you. If you like some cold water, just raise your hand. We'll be glad to deliver that to you while you're waiting as well. We have materials for you to read and different things about our services here, and we pray that you will take advantage of it as well. God's blessing to all of you. Thank you. Do you have cable TV?